Hey guys, welcome back. We're on POV Pool and we are at the Nice Rack. Or it's not the Nice Rack, it's just simply called Nice Rack. In El Cajon, California. A full bar here, five beautiful diamond tables. That's an old picture with the nine footers. There are no nine footers here anymore, and they've decreased the space. They've cut the space in half. I think it's like 5,000 or 6,000 square feet in here now. They've got darts and five of these beautiful bar box diamond tables. And we're going to start our first match here at the SoCal Taps season ending tournament between Jim and Mike versus Oscar and Tyler. So good luck to both players. This is going to be a race of three, and it's Scotch doubles format. So I hope you guys enjoy. This is eight ball Scotch doubles. It looks like Jim and Mike will break. Jim is racking the balls for his teammate, or I don't know. Hold on, maybe it's Oscar and Tyler breaking. Are you Oscar? You're Mike. Okay. So it's Oscar and Tyler breaking. Jim is racking for the loser. And it's winner break or alternate break? And we are alternate break format here. So eight ball, guys. Right here, SoCal Taps summer season-ending event. POV Pool would like to thank Ian Brock and all of the SoCal Tap members for participating in the league this season. Nice little second ball down break. And POV Pool would like to thank our sponsors, Marty Carey's Jump Q, Kamui Tips, and Tiger Products. Also like to thank Roslyn, or Roz, actually, her name is, of Nice Rack. She's the owner here. Want to encourage you guys to come on down. There's a full bar. Plenty of hot food to be had. I see some guys over in the corner eating pizza. We got action at Nice Rack. Oh, and looks like, hey, how are you, Dave? And Dave Martineau just walked in the building.
How you doing?
I know.
I run because I got a contractor at the house. So I just bought a new home.
Cool, man. So, cool. Yeah. This is a nice little place. I like this place. It's nice. Nice atmosphere, you know.
Took out all the big tables, huh?
Yeah. Look at this, man. Cameras, angles, all that. You made the dream come true. You did.
Well, I got to run, but it was good seeing
you.
Oh,
dude, thank you.
Oh, man.
Thank
you so much.
It's good to see you.
Yeah.
Are you still playing? Whenever
I can.
Let me give you a couple of vouchers for some tips. Do you use Kamui Tips?
Actually, I need one, yeah.
Okay, here you go, buddy.
Thank you, buddy. I appreciate it.
Oh, anytime, man. Anytime. I got much love for Mr. Martineau.
Well, it's been so long.
I know.
I haven't been playing for the last month because I've been buying this house.
Oh, right, right. Well, good luck.
Well, it's bought now. It's just getting it where I want to get
it. Fix it up and stuff.
Yeah. All right. Okay. Well, all right. Good seeing you, Dave.
Take care. Thanks for stopping in. Oh, I don't know if you met Geraldine.
Oh, yeah.
This is my better half, Geraldine. Dave Martineau. You remember him?
No, I don't think I've
ever met him. Oh, I've met at hard times once.
Oh,
yeah,
okay.
Yeah,
sorry.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's okay. I'm terrible at names. I remember faces, but then.
Yeah. Good luck on the road, Dave. Good luck with the house.
Thank you.
All right. Send me some pics. Send me an email.
Will.
Okay, buddy. Oh, what a sweetheart. Dave Martineau just came in to say hello, and now he's leaving. A friend and supporter of POV Pool. Very nice guy. Okay, so it looks like Jim and Mike are going to take a seat here Oscar and Tyler. I believe the guy shooting now is Oscar. They're shooting solids. He's going to play some kind of a safety, kicking underneath the 11-1 there. And now the one has gone underneath the 12. So these stripes and solids are both tied up. This is our side view of the table. So, by the way, so I want to get you guys familiar with the TAP League. TAP, when you play doubles in TAP, you have unlimited coaching with each other. Yeah.
Business cards?
A couple. Okay. Unlimited coaching, so basically...
As long as you stay within the 45-second shot clock.
Yeah, as long as you stay within the 45-second shot clock, basically your two minds work as one. So I think it's a very good format for players who want to learn from each other. You know, what we have here is we usually have a stronger player playing with a newer player. And the stronger player will always kind of guide his teammate through. And I just think it's a fabulous way to play when you're getting involved with League. For those who not only want to have fun and compete against better players, but also who want to learn a little bit of the games from your kind of like your mentors. So we recommend the newer players to find those stronger players and match up and play these Scotch doubles events. You were going to say something, Geraldine?
Oh, what are the TAP rules?
I'm sorry?
TAP rules for 8-ball.
TAP rules for 8-ball.
Or call shot, call what?
It's all call pocket. So you don't have to call shot. You don't have to call, like, you know, one off the nine or anything like that. You have to call a combo if you're going to play a combo. You do get to play like a solid stripe combo after the break. It's not take what you make. It's open table after any balls have fallen down.
Ball in hand on the foul?
I believe it is, yes. It's ball in hand. It's been a while since I've played this format. We do have actually the local San Diego operator, Anthony. He's here, and he's going to step on the mic with us too a little later. Beautiful cut on that 14 ball.
Does the 8 count on the break?
I believe it does not, my dear. But hold on. We'll find out right after this game. I'll get a... Rattled. Oscar's down on the 6-ball.
Jump shots are allowed.
Yes, jump shots. I've seen jump shots being performed here. And the 12 goes down. So now it's just a question of, does this 9-ball, I think what he might be looking at is like a billiard. However, I don't think the billiard is on to the side pocket. You guys see that, folks? I think the 1-ball is a little too high above the side for the billiard to happen. Looks like Mike is looking, or Jim, rather, is looking at the more difficult cut, 9-ball. top corner pocket, and it's a no-go. Unfortunately for 8 ball, we all know that if you open up the tied up balls and you miss your last ball, it's almost suicide, because now your opponent usually has an open shot. In this case, looks like Jim and Mike got a roll, and Tyler now is playing a safety. He's going to kick into the six slowly, and I think he's going to just... Oh, no, you can make the six, sir. Good shot. Walk the dog down the rail. And he overcut it. And now the nine is open, but look what he's done to the eight.
That's a fancy wallet chain.
Fancy chain wallet, you said? Oh, yeah. Okay. Yeah. Well, you know, it's pool players are trendsetters, Geraldine.
Keep this coupon is what it says.
POV Pool says hello to Jeff Gray. Jeff Gray, the bandit. Grr.
Is he only playing on one table?
From Las Vegas.
Oh, right now he is.
I'm sorry. Overcut the nine. And I tell you what, this ain't no bag of Jolly Ranchers for Oscar and Tyler either, so.
Is it win or break?
It's alternate break, my love.
Alternate break, like the last person who should be shooting breaks?
Oh, as far as the Scotch format is concerned, I'm assuming that the players have to maintain their rotation even in between racks.
So, like,
I could be wrong.
End up breaking every single time.
Yeah.
If it's your turn on the rotation.
Yeah, I may need a refresher on all of that, but as far as I can I remember, you do have to maintain your rotation. Which is good, because then, you know, it not only evens out the field and evens out the teams. Oh, wow, that bank almost went. Not only evens out the teams, but it also gives your, two players a chance to try breaking.
Well, no.
And get used to breaking.
So then you're saying that if I broke the last rack and two racks later...
No, and I don't mean it that way. I mean it if your opponent or if your teammate made the eight ball, then you have to break. Do you get what I'm saying?
Yeah. So.
So if your teammate made the eight ball, you have to break. So that's the rotation I'm talking about. I believe. But we could just be...
I have to know this. I'm playing.
All right. Oh, you are playing. That's right. Who's your teammate, by the way?
Jeff.
Sorensen?
No.
Oh, a different Jeff?
Yeah.
What's he, a six, seven?
Five.
He's a five?
So I have to play at the level of a five.
You need money from me? Is that...
Oh, yes. I'll need
my
that.
Hat's off to you, by the way. But, you know, it's not a big field today, so...
He said he's paying out to eight. Not that I care about the payout.
That's all I can do right now. You need more?
I need 30.
Here, just take that and give me change.
He's paying out to eight, but I just want a trophy.
You'll probably get a trophy.
I've never gotten a pool trophy.
That's great. Geraldine Thibodeau is in the field. All right, so these boys here, Oscar and... this looks like Oscar. Still, I do not see these guys closing out unless Tyler plays a great shot on this one ball.
Be right back. I have to find out from Ian Brock the rules.
Oh. Mr. Jeff Gray. Wow, he did play a great shot, and now Oscar has the added pressure of having to make this eight ball in. I love eight ball, guys. Great game. Great, great game. It's a thinking man's game. It has all the elements of every game you've played in pool. It has elements of straight pool, one pocket, nine ball, 10 ball, and it's just a great game. Even banks once in a while.
Is alternate break or?
Yes, alternate break is what I heard. So, Oscar and Tyler. Oscar plays a nice shot on the eight ball to the side pocket, and it is 1-0. Oscar Tyler versus Jim Mike.
Alternate break.
So we're right
in for them.
Alternate break format.
When in doubt, just shoot. You. When in doubt, you just take the cable and shoot.
Welcome back, guys. POV Pool, POVpool.com. Please share, tell a friend. We're streaming live all day. And we'll probably be here until about 10 p.m. But I want to remind you guys, it's a very short field today. Very short field today. Only 10 teams came to this new location down in El Cajon, California. So tough action to get these regular tap players to drive almost 100 miles to come to Nice Rack. So what I mean by this is we are going to try to arrange some action to happen after this tournament. The tournament probably will be over around 6, and we got some action lined up. And when I mean action, I'm going to get into the box with Jeff Sorensen, I believe. He wants to play me some $50 sets, $100 sets. So we'll see what happens. He's going to play me either 9 ball or 8 ball. So, fear not, guys. Outside of league action, we're going to have some open action right here on POV Pool. Please don't forget to stay tuned later tonight. So, here's Mike and his teammate Jim. Looks like they're gonna take on solids. And this break is very different from the last break we saw, because all the balls are wide open, and if Jim and Mike can maintain good cue ball control, they have a good chance to run out and win this second game. Looks like POV Pool is also going to be streaming in October a couple of dates, so be sure to subscribe to my website, POVpool.com, and we'll be sure to release a schedule soon. And by the way, POV is going to be doing its own tournament in February 2016.
I have a clarification on the rule.
Oh, good.
Okay, so it's alternating break, and it's also alternating break between the players.
Between your teammates?
So it's not a continuation of the rotation.
Oh, that's cool. So, but it's a continuation of the, it's kind of a rotation between racks. So, yeah, I see what you're saying.
No, but
like,
even still,
I broke last time, you have to break this time.
Yeah, regardless if
that's
I made
cool.
the eight ball the last time.
I like
time.
That. I like
and
that.
And if you're the other team, so let's say the other team broke, whoever wants to step up and shoot first from my team can step up and shoot. Like, it's not a continuation of the rotation from last game.
Oh, okay, so you can take a look at the table layout and say, you know what, I don't want to shoot the first shot. You can shoot it.
Correct.
That's great. Just all kinds of options here. Okay, so Tyler shooting stripes, swing and a miss, and the first ball tied up, 6-10. Actually, those aren't really tied up that bad, but Jim and Mike are solids, and looks like they don't really have anything. However, I think if Mike can kind of slam the 6 into the 10, the billiard could be on, but he's going to have to cut it a little bit as well, and you got to use the right spin. And I believe the correct spin is, for this shot, you use right-hand spin and cut that ball. Let it slide off the 10 into the side. Just like that. Just like that. Great shot. So unable to close out, here comes Oscar and Tyler. They're up one game in a race of 3. And these boys just have to drop these balls in one at a time. They're all wide open. I would use probably the 13 ball as the key ball. That's one that's by the side pocket. Nice little exhibition of stroke there by Tyler, but you know, as far as 8 ball is concerned, it may have been slightly unnecessary. Is it totally unnecessary? Playing on these bar box tables, you know, 8 ball is not really a game of moving the cue ball so much as, you know, you got to move the cue. What I mean is pocket speed shots are generally preferred in the game of bar box 8 ball. So now, because of the shape, Tyler has to take down the key ball that I was talking about. And this is a perfect example here. Like, so you see that 10 ball down at the top rail, or bottom rail, whichever, bottom rail really. Again. That's not a ball you want to have as your key ball, but because of the position they're in right now, Oscar has to shoot the 15. It's an easier shot, and he's going to leave Tyler with an extremely difficult shot on this 10, unless he's got enough angle to do something. Let's see. Nope, he doesn't.
Yeah.
Okay. Ball in hand, and Mike and Jim have been given a gift and look like they are going to tie this up. Monk the Assassin just entered the chat room. Hello. Welcome back. Thanks for watching. Ooh. Oh, man. I don't know. I didn't take a look at how he got down on that shot there, but tell you what, plenty of opportunity for billiard lessons and pool lessons in these smaller leagues. All you instructors out there that are looking to pick up some students. You know, these guys, I'm sure they would love the help. And it makes for great development of the game and for leagues when players get better and they start to win tournaments. Cross-side bank, unsuccessful by Oscar. Here comes Mike with the Mike and Jim team and their second attempt on the eight ball. So funny, watch. I'm watching Geraldine take selfies.
It's my kamui shirt.
In her kamui shirt. And pocket speed, the eight ball goes down. It's 1-1, fist bumps by Mike and Jim. So you players out there looking for new cues, I'm going to remind you to check out tigerproducts.com. Check out only the best in billiard equipment, tigerproducts.com. Made in the USA, distributed right here out of California, and from a few other dealers all across the country. Tiger Products. Sponsors Dennis Orcolio, Pedro Piedrabuena, Melissa Herndon, Christine De La Garza. And there are many people that I know that have changed their game with the Tiger. Pro X, Ultra LD shafts, and many, many other cues and accessories that can be available at Tiger Products.
Oh, no, no. Just stick to... You're probably more like a
six. Are you
this is Jeff?
Yeah.
Hey, how you doing?
Dad. Daniel.
Thanks for... Geraldine really wanted to play this, so...
Yeah, cool. I'm glad I could come out here and play.
Yeah.
So I'm going to play more like a five. But I'm probably more like a three. But I'm going to play like a five today.
I did bump me up. I was a four in APA, and I came over and started playing with you guys. And then I, my first, very first game, I had a break and run against like a seven. And that, boom, I'm going to a five.
I have high hopes for it.
But it made me feel good in that sense because you have to play up to your expectations.
Yeah.
That'd be pretty good.
You're taking on a trophy.
Okay.
That's my
goal. That's the incentive is focused.
cash value?
I don't know. I just want to.
She likes the cash, too.
Yeah. Trophies are good. And if you win a trophy, if they just give you one per team, you have it.
Thank you.
All right, guys. So here we are. This break is a little different than the last break. So Mike is, what's he measuring here? He's looking at something. I think we still got an open table, if I'm not mistaken. I took my eyes off this match, so I apologize. But I think we're looking at an open table. Mike is taking on the 2-1 combo. Watch out for that 8-ball, sir. Oh. Yeah, I don't know what happened there. What do you need?
I plan on cleaning up this time.
You're not this. Do it for me this last time, huh? But just don't get shitty.
So we're going to take this time also to check in with Ian Brock. How you doing, Ian, man? It's nice to be back here in El Cajon. Well, actually, not back here, but back here with you.
Yeah, Dan, we're here. We're at the most intimate setting that we've had thus far, and everybody's having a good time.
Yeah, I've told the audience, you know, we have slightly short field for this summer season event. You had a lot of players that normally play with the Tap League that, you know, have to drive about 100 miles, so I guess you took a little bit of a gamble on that.
Yeah, well, there's a few from San Jacinto that had to come 90. Most people have to drive about an hour from where we are.
Yeah.
But these guys down here have driven north for the last four, you know, individual tournaments, and it's fair. You know, we come down and make it happen. But there's a little bit different demographic up north than there is down south. And, you know, but we're having a good time. And we're going to do a raffle today that has no, you can't buy a raffle ticket. So everybody gets a raffle ticket. That's it. So everybody's going to have an equal chance on one of these really nice queues that we're going to be going out. So it should be fun.
Oh, nice.
We're
going to
be, yeah, a lot of people are going to get them. And we're going to limit, everybody's going to, if you win a queue, then you're out for the next one. So that gives everybody's going to get a queue here. A lot of people are getting.
That's one thing I've always liked about the events that you do, Ian, is you've always been really generous with the raffles, and you've given away a lot of merchandise and t-shirts and swag, and you know, that's what players love too. You know, I mean, I've seen players, you know, their faces light up because they don't really have a good cue, you know,
right.
They're just
right.
playing with like a sneaky Pete that's not playing too good. It's their first $50 cue, and then you know, they'll come and get a raffle ticket for playing in one of these tournaments. They end up walking away with like a $300-$400 queue, you know.
And yeah, it's a really good deal. I mean, we pay out higher than anybody else. We pay out 58.75%. We charge $8. You get back $4.65 to the players. It comes in three different pots. And
cool.
So there's three different tournaments each session as well. So if you can't make this one, the next one will be back up north and
another season ender.
And these guys will have to drive up there for the next time.
Yeah.
Which will be
when we say up north, we say like Temecula area.
I think we'll probably go back to Pit Stop. We'll see what
Pit
happens.
Pit Stop Hub. Okay.
Yeah, and the first one is the title holders. That's the money pot. The second one is the Scotch doubles here, which is where you get the money and your trophies from the title holder, but you also get this raffle money that goes into it as well. And then the third pot is the national fund. But then we also have a little sliver for the Captain's MVP tournament. That's what we're going to end up having up north. So it's really, there's three tournaments per session, and then you actually have a standalone tournament, which is the national qualifier, which will happen next year. We just we just had that here a month ago or so, and had our team win, and we're going off to Nashville, Tennessee for the national championships in November.
Awesome,
yeah,
dude.
Yeah, it'll
awesome.
Be a lot of fun.
Also, I wanted to, you know, just let everybody know we're in El Cajon too, because you've experienced a little bit of growth with the tap, with the, you know, Tap League, SoCal Tap League. Into the San Diego area in Orange County.
Yeah.
And so, you know, you wanted to give other venues a chance to showcase some of your events.
You can't, you know, you just never know when you're going in a new spot. So it's just what it is. And but the people came here, are going to have a good time today. And again,
and you have a new operator down here too, Anthony. What's
Anthony
his last
Schrode.
Name?
Anthony Schrode, and also Teresita Brooks. She's in the north and Anthony's in the south. And,
okay. North County, South County.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
So, yeah, it's... you just can't. You can't call. The thing is, we added in an extra three tournaments per year. So basically, if you're in the north or the south, you're still going to get one. You know, and so there's people that just realize that, and it's just easier not to drive, and they're going to pick up the next one. So the next one is that Captain's MVP tournament, that generated just over $700, and it's available for those people that are captains and have, you know, secured the MVP spot.
Hold on a second. Is it race to two or three?
It's race to three.
So race to two or three?
Race
to three.
Race to three.
Yeah.
Race to three.
Yeah, these guys were fist bumping and shaking hands. We're talking race to three, guys. Yeah, yeah. premature celebration.
Yep. Race to three.
Oscar and Tyler.
Race to three on the winners, race to two on the losers today.
Ah, there you
because
go.
Because we have the limited field, you know.
Right.
It's a tough one.
Yeah.
Down here,
yeah.
There's a lot younger demographic, and a lot of those guys are working the weekends, and it's just what it is. But
yeah.
We're having a good time, so.
All right, so these guys are not done yet. You know, Ian, I want to thank you again for allowing us to come down here, you know, and work with you. It's been almost 4 years now, so.
Yeah, it's my pleasure, Dan. I always enjoy having you down here, and it really helps us. And the people that are listening in, we're always looking for new players. You can go to www.socaltab.com and become a member and come try it out and play the highest-paying league that's out here. So.
Yeah, absolutely. Do it now, socaltab.com. I'll just put that in the chat room as well. And we'll be sure to be seeing and hearing more from me and Brock in the coming years. So these guys, you know, it's kind of embarrassing, but, you know, Oscar and Tyler did a chest bump. And unfortunately for them, they're not done. Chest bump. Whoops. Let me get rid of that. Thank you.
Or you can play on the center table here if you'd like to do it. I'm a nice guy.
Geraldine is going to get in her match. She's playing with a guy named Jeff. He's a 5, she's a 2. Good luck. Good luck, my love. Get a trophy. Eight ball. Nice finesse, slow shot on that 15 ball. These boys got to make 5 more balls to produce another appropriate chest bump. Tyler, who just shot that ball, has a fiery little stroke. He likes to spear those balls in with a little authority. Oscar, he's kind of the finesse player of the two. Likes to consider his cue ball. So, concentration here. The 11 ball is a good ball to take down last. But not necessarily from that angle. I don't know if they're going to get a chance to even shoot at this 8. If the 11 goes down, it's going to be extremely difficult to get shape on the 8 ball. They might have to play some kind of a bank or... That's what's so hard about 8 ball. You know, you make all your... Make all your balls on the table except for that 8 ball, and essentially you end up leaving yourself open for the opponent. That's what makes 8 ball such a great game, is forces you to make decisions early in the rack and late in the rack. But the decisions you make early in the rack strategically can highly affect your performance. And look at this. Look at this. He's going to get shape on the 8, and I think they're good. I think this 8 ball goes. There's a 5-6 ball run out here. All right. Come on now. Chest bump. Let's do it. All right. Whoa. Oh, wait, you got to do it right here, man. I got the camera. I got, yeah, there you go. Right there. That's the one right there. Right there. Yeah, there you go.
Oh, my God. This is funny.
POV pool, man. Let's do it. All right. Yeah, I'm ready for the next match. Who we got, Ian?
It's
going
to be Jeff and Geraldine.
Ah.
Versus Anthony and Sita, S-I-T-A.
All right. Coming up, Jeff and Geraldine versus Anthony and Sita. Race of three. In about 2 seconds, so don't go anywhere, guys. We're gonna start this match right now.
Hopefully I don't like it.